All right, so it's been a couple days since the first of these. Very unfortunate start. But luckily, fate has decided to, you know, throw me a bone, make it up to me with the second movie, which is a movie I'm actually looking forward to seeing, and a movie I really, really don't remember. But what I do remember of it, I remember being good, and people say it's good. So today's movie is Aladdin 2, Return of Jafar. Now, anybody that knows me knows that Aladdin is my favorite Disney movie. Like, bar none. I love that movie. I love that movie so much. So if this turns out to be bad, I'm going to be really angry, but I have a lot of confidence that it won't turn out to be bad, like the last one, which made me angry. Really angry. So yeah, I'm going to go over there now. I'm going to go eat a plate of curly fries, drink a couple cans of root beer, and watch Return of Jafar. And I'll see you guys when I get back. Alright.
Gotta eat to live, gotta steal to eat, tell you all about it when I got the time.
Alright, so, watched the movie all the way through. It was pretty good. I mean, it wasn't as good as the first movie. I didn't expect it to be. But it was enjoyable. Couple things. The animation quality was a lot lesser, mainly because the television animation guys handled this movie instead of the actual, like, animation people, which doesn't surprise me at all, but it, I don't know, it looked a little off. Jason Alexander plays a character. I didn't know that. He plays the bandit Abysmal, who is sort of another villain, but not really, because obviously the main villain's Jafar. But he was pretty good. He nailed the part. Jason Alexander is pretty great. I like him. Which gives me a lot of hope for another one of my movies, because he was in the original, and I'm hoping they brought him back for the sequel. So, I don't know. So I don't remember anything about that sequel. Okay, so the whole movie takes place who the hell knows how long after the first Aladdin movie, and Aladdin's still stealing from bandits, and he's just like flying over and doing air raids with treasure over Agrabah and just dropping treasure in front of everybody, and everybody's like, oh yeah, this is never brought up again, by the way. I guess this is just here to show that Aladdin's the good guy, in case you didn't already know that Aladdin's the good guy. But see, some problems I had with it. Dan Castellaneta, he does a great genie. But obviously, he had to get good at that genie, because he was okay in this movie, but just okay. And I'm sorry if you can hear background noise there. His desk is right up against my roommate. I don't know if you can hear him, but eh. So yeah, Dan Castellaneta still sounded a lot like Homer, and less like Robin Williams. And I know he gets better at that part later with practice, so hey, I can handle it. They gave Gilbert Gottfried a lot of 2 whole musical numbers in this movie. I think this movie was more about Iago than it was about Aladdin. which is weird, but I guess it worked. But like I said, he got 2 whole musical numbers to himself. Though one was sort of shared with Jasmine, but for the most part it was two to himself. Genie only got 1, but Jafar got 1. Which was basically, from what I got, it was basically Friend Like Me, but with Jafar singing it instead of the genie. And that was pretty cool. Only Second Rate, Your Only Second Rate is, I don't know if that's the actual name. I haven't looked up much. But it was a pretty good song. Didn't like the new voice actress for Jasmine. Was not a fan. Was not a fan at all. She just sounded really bad. And I don't know what else that lady's done. For all I know, that actress has done a lot of other good roles, and she's actually a very good voice actress. I don't know. Not familiar with her work, wasn't familiar with the name. All I know is that she was different from the one in the first movie. She wasn't great. Too high-pitched for my tastes. What else? The second song that Gilbert Gottfried had, that Iago had, that he shared with Jasmine, wasn't a great song, but the animation sequence was pretty good, and I liked that. This video is not going to be nearly as long as the Mulan 2 one, because it's a lot easier to talk about a movie I didn't like than it is to talk about a movie I did like. I don't know, a lot of the times the animation would sort of get on my nerves, but like I said, that's kind of to be expected when you hand this to your television animation people and say, hey, this is a direct-to-DVD movie, take it, go. Which made me a little miffed, because Mulan 2 looked a lot better than this, which means they spent more budget on making Aladdin 2 than they did on making Mulan 2, though I think Aladdin 2 came first. I'm pretty sure these were made fairly quickly after the first movie, if I remember correctly, or I guess this would be a straight-to-video sequel, not straight-to-DVD, because this was VHS era. That's hard to remember. Because I remember watching the third one when I was really, really, really young. And by really, really, really young, I mean I'm pretty sure I watched it the night my sister was born. Don't quote me on that story. I'm probably 100% wrong on those memories. I don't remember what year King of Thieves came out. We're not talking about King of Thieves. We're here to talk about Return of Jafar. Jafar was pretty great still. It was still Jonathan Freeman. They had a different voice for Aladdin to sing. And I don't remember if that was a thing in the first movie. I don't think it was. I'm pretty sure his singing voice and speaking voice were the same guy. Because it was the same guy that came back for speaking, but it was a different guy who was singing, so I don't know what was going on there, but eh. Can't say any of the musical numbers were all that memorable, but like I said, overall, pretty good movie. And I don't have anything else to say about this movie. It's seriously a lot easier to talk about a movie I hated, a la Mulan 2, where I went on a 20-minute rant, than it is to talk about a movie I like. Like, this is probably only going to hit about 10 minutes long. So that is all for this session. Next movie, next vlog comes out on Saturday. Look forward to it. I'll see you guys then. Bye. No friends got abracadabra. Let it rip! And then make the sucker disappear. So don't you sit there, smack your bunky hide. I'm here to answer all your business friends. You got me bona fide, certified. You got a genie for a child to pay. To help you out, so what you wish, I really wanna know. You got a list that's 3 miles long, no doubt. Well, all you gotta do is rub like so. Hey ho, Mr. Aladdin, sir, have a wish or two or three. I'm on the job, you big nabob. You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend. Never had a friend like me.